the vast expanse of our universe, amidst the twinkling constellations and the mysteries they hold, one question remains persistent. Are we alone, not just in the universe, but what about in our minds? When we think of a hive mind, images often arise of the mesmerizing intricacies of nature, vast armies of ants navigating treacherous terrains, moving in harmony like a flowing river of purpose, or bees in their wondrous hives, each individual embarking on precisely choreographed flight patterns, gathering, communicating, creating. There's an incredible beauty in observing these tiny beings. Though they might appear insignificant in isolation, together they become a force of nature, demonstrating the power of collective will and action. Each ant, with its role so distinctly defined, from the soldier guarding the sanctum of their mound to the forager venturing into the vastness of the world, is a cog in a beautifully synchronized mechanism. Their trails, if watched from above, form patterns of such exquisite complexity, intertwining yet never colliding. It's a dance, one choreographed by eons of evolution and survival. One cannot help but be in awe of this masterclass of collaboration. Similarly, bees, with their hexagonal homes and meticulously structured societies, are an embodiment of nature's precision. The queen bee, the diligent workers, and the protective drones each play their part to sustain and nurture the hive. Their dance, the fabled waggle dance, is not just a delightful display, but an intricate communication system relaying vital information about food sources, directions, and distances. This silent language, spoken in vibrations and movements, is the testament to an understanding that goes beyond the individual. So, when we witness such marvels in the natural world, it raises a profoundly intriguing question. Is it conceivable that we humans, with our layered emotions, ambitions, dreams, and fears, are part of a similar, albeit more nuanced, collective? While our societies have complexities that seem galaxies away from these tiny creatures, could there be an underlying current, a subtle thread of unity binding us? Our cities, with their towering skyscrapers and bustling streets, might seem chaotic, but zoom out and patterns emerge. The flow of traffic, the rhythm of daily life, the collective moods that sway with events, both local and global. Could these not be our version of the ant trails or the bee dances? Our music festivals, parades, and even silent vigils bear witness to our ability to move, feel, and act as one. Like a hive, we too resonate with shared joys, sorrows, hopes, and dreams. Thus, the concept of a hive mind is not entirely alien to our human experience. Perhaps it's subtly woven into our very fabric, waiting for the right moment or the right lens of observation to reveal itself in its full glory. Delve deep into the wisdom of ancient civilizations, and you embark on a journey through time, through the whispers of the ancients echoing in the annals of history. Each civilization, in its unique voice, has told tales of a universe intricately bound together, not just by tangible threads, but also by the ethereal ties of spirit and consciousness. The Greeks, with their vast pantheon and philosophical giants, gave us the concept of anima mundi, the world soul. This wasn't just a poetic notion, but a foundational belief. The anima mundi was thought to be the pure ethereal spirit that breathed life into all matter, connecting everything from the mightiest gods to the smallest pebble. Plato mused upon this idea, suggesting that the world in its entirety was a living being with a soul. Could this grand vision of the world not hint at an early understanding of a global hive mind? But it wasn't just the Greeks. Journey across time to the land of the pharaohs, and you find the ancient Egyptians believed in Ka, a life force that every person possesses, linking them to the cosmos. Every individual's Ka was a fragment of the greater life force, emphasizing a collective consciousness that permeated their rituals and daily lives. Now let's traverse vast oceans and dense forests to the indigenous tribes, who often lived in harmony with nature. Their world wasn't divided by artificial boundaries. To them, the spirit flowed ubiquitously. Every gust of wind, rustle of leaves, the murmur of flowing rivers, all carried tales of interconnected souls. The Native Americans, for instance, believed in the Great Spirit, a singular entity that connected every living thing. The tribes of the African plains, the shamans of the Amazon rainforest, or the aboriginals of Australia all shared a profound understanding that everything and everyone was part of a greater whole. Their rituals, dances, and songs celebrated this interconnectedness. Could this pervasive belief across cultures, across ages, be anything but an intuitive grasp of the hive mind? Fast forward to today, and our journey takes a fascinating turn. No longer are these beliefs relegated to the realm of the esoteric or mythological. The hallowed halls of science, which once prided themselves on dissection and compartmentalization, are now witnessing a convergence. Fields as seemingly disparate as quantum mechanics and neurobiology are finding common ground. In the quantum realm, particles separated by vast distances seem to communicate instantaneously, challenging our understanding of space and time. This phenomenon, known as quantum entanglement, has left scientists both baffled and intrigued. Could there be a parallel in the way human minds interact, where thoughts and emotions ripple across the collective consciousness? Meanwhile, neurobiologists are discovering patterns in the brain that resonate with the rhythms of the universe. Neural networks, with their intricate web of connections, mirror the vast networks of galaxies. As we map the human brain, we begin to see patterns that suggest our individual minds might just be nodes in a grand, interconnected network. It's a thrilling age of discovery, where ancient wisdom and modern research are dancing together, hinting that perhaps, just perhaps, we've always been more connected than we ever fathomed. Let's embark on a journey into the enigmatic realm of quantum entanglement, a cornerstone of quantum mechanics that has been teasing, challenging, and even sometimes mocking our conventional understanding of reality. At its heart, this phenomenon describes the curious way in which particles, once they've interacted, become irreversibly intertwined. So profound is this connection that a change in the state of one particle, even if separated by vast cosmic distances, immediately induces a change in its partner. It's as if they communicate beyond the constraints of space and time, defying the very tenets of classical physics. Albert Einstein famously referred to this mystifying link as spooky action at a distance. Despite his initial reservations, countless experiments have since solidified the existence of this quantum quirk. But this leaves us pondering, what does this deep connection between subatomic particles tell us about the nature of connectivity itself? If particles, the tiniest constituents of matter, can exhibit such profound interdependence, could it offer insights into more macroscopic connections, say, between human minds? Venture beyond the subatomic and into the realm of human psyche, and you encounter phenomena equally as intriguing. Psychologists, with their tools of observation and analysis, have catalogued myriad events that defy straightforward explanations. Take, for instance, shared dreams, where individuals, regardless of distance or prior communication, dream strikingly similar scenarios on the same night. Or consider the collective euphoria that envelops a crowd at concerts, where thousands in unison sway to a rhythm, transcending their individual identities. Sports events are another canvas where this collective consciousness paints its wonders. A stadium roaring in elation or sinking in shared despair, the emotions aren't just contagious, they seem to originate from a shared mental space. And then there are moments of mass panics, where cities or even countries are gripped by a singular fear, transcending logic or reason. In our modern age, the sudden, almost synchronized global adoption of technological trends serves as another testament. One moment, a gadget or app is a mere concept, and the next, it's a global phenomenon, integrated seamlessly into daily routines across continents. Are these waves of global adoption merely the outcomes of effective marketing? Or could they be ripples in our collective consciousness, nudging humanity in unison? Pulling from both the bewildering world of quantum mechanics and the intricate tapestry of human experiences, one can't help but speculate. Perhaps these aren't just isolated phenomena or mere coincidences. Instead, they might be glimpses into a vast interconnected web of consciousness, hinting at the grandeur of a universe more deeply linked than we've ever realized. Ah, life serendipities! Picture this, you're leisurely strolling through a park, lost in your thoughts, humming a long-forgotten tune from your childhood. Suddenly, like an echo from the universe, a passerby mirrors your melody, note for note. It's almost magical, isn't it? Or those moments when a dormant question, perhaps something you haven't contemplated in ages, bubbles up in your mind. And then, lo and behold, you find that very question being hotly debated on your favorite social media platform the very next morning. It's as if the universe tapped into your midnight musings. Such delightful synchronicities often leave us chuckling, pondering the playfulness of existence. Are these mere coincidences, or are they perhaps the universe's way of giving us a gentle nudge, a wink, reminding us of the invisible threads weaving us together? Maybe it's just the universe having its own version of a little jest, a cosmic giggle at the patterns we sometimes fail to recognize. Yet, as we bask in these whimsical moments, we must also confront the profound implications that come with the idea of a collective consciousness. It's not all light-hearted synchronicities and shared melodies. The notion that our thoughts, emotions, and experiences might be interwoven into a grand tapestry presents myriad complexities. For starters, where does individuality fit in this expansive framework? If we're all tapping into a shared reservoir of thoughts and feelings, to what extent can we claim our ideas as uniquely our own? This isn't just a philosophical conundrum, but poses tangible ethical dilemmas. In a world where intellectual property is fiercely guarded, if an idea surfaces simultaneously in the minds of two individuals, who gets the credit? Who, if anyone, truly owns a thought? Moreover, as we venture further into the digital age, with technology evolving at a breathtaking pace, the boundaries between individual and collective become even more blurred. Algorithms, with their uncanny ability to predict our desires, often seem to be one step ahead, suggesting content that eerily aligns with our recent musings. It begs the question, in an era where our digital footprints are vast and interconnected, how do we safeguard the sanctity of our shared mental space? How do we ensure that this collective consciousness, this hive mind, isn't exploited or manipulated? It's a delicate balance, intertwining the whimsical with the profound, the individual with the collective. As we stand on the precipice of understanding, we must tread carefully, cherishing the magic while also grappling with the profound responsibilities it brings. Picture, if you will, a world transformed by the recognition of our profound interconnectedness, a society where the threads of collective consciousness are not just acknowledged, but revered and integrated into every facet of life. Such a world would be remarkably different from the one we know today. Education, the cornerstone of this new society, would undergo a radical metamorphosis. The classrooms of this world would hum with a different energy. No longer would they be arenas for individual competition, where students jostle for ranks and accolades. Instead, they'd be vibrant hubs of collaborative learning, where each student's success uplifts the whole, where knowledge is viewed not as a personal treasure to hoard, but as a gift to share. The metrics of achievement would shift from individual grades to collective milestones. We'd celebrate not just the valedictorian who excels in exams, but also the empath who brings harmony, the mediator who resolves conflicts, and the dreamer who inspires peers with visionary ideas. Beyond the classrooms, our urban landscapes would reflect this newfound reverence for interconnectedness. City planning would no longer be a mere exercise in logistics, laying down roads and erecting buildings. It would be an art, a delicate dance of creating spaces that foster human connection. Parks would be designed not just as green oases, but as communal hearts where people converge, share, and bond. Buildings would prioritize communal spaces, encouraging inhabitants to engage, converse, and co-create. Even our transportation systems would be reimagined. Instead of isolated compartments, we'd have open, shared spaces where travelers can exchange stories, ideas, and perhaps even forge lifelong connections. However, with this embrace of the collective, there would also be a newfound respect for individuality. Recognizing our interconnectedness doesn't mean dissolving the self. Instead, it means understanding that each unique individual contributes to the beauty and richness of the collective tapestry. Every voice, every story, every dream would be cherished, for it adds a unique hue to the mosaic of human experience. Yet, as alluring as this vision is, we must ground ourselves in the realm of reality. The concept of a hive mind, while enchanting, remains a theory, a captivating idea that beckons us with its possibilities. Science, with its unwavering commitment to truth and evidence, will persistently probe this concept. Experiments will be designed, hypotheses tested, and findings scrutinized. And as with all theories, there will be debates, critiques, and challenges. Some studies may offer tantalizing glimpses into our interconnected nature, while others may raise skeptical eyebrows. But that's the beauty of science. It's an ever-evolving journey, a dance between curiosity and skepticism, wonder and rigor. Whether the hive mind theory stands the test of time or evolves into something entirely different, one thing is certain. The quest for understanding the intricate web of human consciousness will continue to inspire, challenge, and captivate us for generations to come. As the indigo curtain of night descends and the cacophony of the day gradually fades into the serene lull of the evening, let us take a moment to journey inward, to the vast universe that lies within each of us. Each thought that flutters across the landscape of our minds, whether it be a fond memory, a lingering regret, a momentary joy, or a burning aspiration, might not be solitary. Picture it not as an isolated ripple in a still pond, but as a gentle wave intertwined with countless others in the boundless ocean of collective consciousness. That gentle tug of intuition, that unexplainable hunch that often guides our actions. Could it be whispers from ages past, or echoes from countless souls navigating similar paths? Consider the emotions that course through us, the fleeting bursts of elation, the shadows of melancholy, the pangs of longing, or the flames of passion. While they might feel deeply personal, could they also be reflections of a shared emotional heritage? Perhaps every time we experience joy, we're tapping into an ancient reservoir of collective happiness, and every sorrow we feel resonates with the heartaches of countless beings before us and around us. As the darkness deepens and the stars take their positions in the vast tapestry of the cosmos, it's humbling to think that just as they are bound by cosmic forces, our souls might be interconnected by ethereal threads. Threads spun not just from experiences, but from hopes, dreams, fears, and loves that transcend time and space. So, dear voyagers of the vast landscapes of consciousness, as you nestle into the embrace of your beds, remember, you are not alone. The thoughts you think, the dreams you dream, they could be part of a grand, eternal symphony, a testament to our shared journey through the intricacies of existence. Good night, dear travelers of the mind. As you embark on your nocturnal journeys through dreamscapes and realms unknown, may you do so with an insatiable curiosity. May the tapestries of your dreams be woven with threads of wonder and understanding, and may they always dance harmoniously in rhythm with the heartbeat of our shared humanity. Rest well, and remember, every dawn brings with it new mysteries to unravel and new stories to be woven into our collective saga. Goodbye for now, dear traveler. We shall see each other soon. Subscribe for more.